Delius made France his home for the last 46 of his 72 years. And France was also one of Beecham's very favourite countries, if not his absolute favourite land in the world. He particularly spent long periods there in the last few years of his life, partly because of problems with the British Inland Revenue, but also partly because he loved the French culture and the country's people, and in the south, where he used to stay in his very last years, its climate. He once complained that the climate in England made it impossible to live there, while the tax situation made it too expensive to die there. Embedded in his love and deep knowledge of French literature, music and art was his acute sensibility to the musical styles and colours of France's greatest composers. We've already heard in this documentary how he made the very different characteristics of Berlioz and Massenet come alive so idiomatically, and many people have felt he captured the subtle balances of yet another very different personality, Georges Bizet, to perfection. In Bizet's incidental music for Alphonse Daudet's play L'Arlésienne, The Girl from Arles, the composer evoked the tragic and romantic atmosphere of desperate, unrequited love in a 19th-century Provençal village, with a very subtle fusion of delicacy and passion, as the heartbroken Frédéric, unable to stop thinking of the girl he now can't marry, finally throws himself off the top window of his home to his death, while the celebrations for the festival of Saint-Éloi are taking place. The orchestral suites that Bizet drew up for concert performance were recorded by Beecham and the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra in 1956, and the poignant tenderness and intense yearning of the playing is embodied in some of the most remarkable melding of expressive rubato and rhythmic control ever achieved by these artists. Here's the second half of the first movement of the first suite, beginning with the saxophone solo played by Walter Lear, expressing the simple-minded but sensitive younger brother of Frédéric, L'Innocent, who tries in vain to comfort him. This leads into the fervent but anguished music associated with Frédéric's love.